So way back in the day, I'm talking about in 2011, I released my review of the original Harbeth P3ESR, and I liked them. In fact, not only did I like them enough to buy the review sample, I also ended up keeping that review sample for 7 years, which is nearly a record for me. And while I used the Harbeth P3 and mostly the desktop application, they brought me countless hours of listening pleasure, and that's why I'm so excited to share with you all my thoughts on the 40th anniversary model of this speaker, because let's face it, it's basically the same speaker with a different aesthetic and some upgraded parts on the inside. So in this video, what I want to do is not only tell you all what this product sounds like as a whole, but most importantly, go over those differences and to share my thoughts on whether or not those differences are worth the upgrade. So with that being said, welcome to my review of the Harbeth 40th anniversary version of the P3ESR. All right, so I'm going to kick off this review with a brief history lesson just because these speakers can trace their lineage all the way back to the early 1970s. And it all got started when the BBC, and I'm referring to British Broadcasting, not the other BBC, you dirty-minded people, basically said, hey, look, we need a set of small speakers that we can use to monitor the quality of our programs, and we need these speakers to work in tight spaces like control rooms and vans. And not only that, the speakers need to sound natural and pretty dynamic for their size. And thus the LS35A was born. Now since then, 11 manufacturers have been given the license at one point or another to produce the LS35A to include Harbeth. In fact, Harbeth was actually founded by the head of loudspeaker design at the BBC. Of course, I'm referring to Dudley Harwood. Now, what you're looking at here is essentially a modern interpretation or an homage to the original LS35A design. A lot of the key elements are there, but you can't really call this an LS35A by purist standards, but still, it has a lot of the spirit inside the speaker, and that leads me to the 40th anniversary and what it's all about. I really want to tell you guys why Harbeth released the 40th anniversary line and what it is that you're getting with it. So let's cut to that right now. All right, so to keep this section as short and as sweet as possible, let's first go over what it is that you get with any of the 40th anniversary versions of the Harbeth product. So in a nutshell, the first thing you're going to notice is a unique veneer. And in the case of the P3ESR, you get this beautiful olive wood veneer. It's nice and textured. It's classy. I just love it. I'm not sure if my pictures or the video does any justice to this product, but it really does look great in person. Beyond that, all the products feature internal upgrades like better caps, better internal wiring, and of course, fancy binding posts. But the big question is why? Beyond just selling more product, which of course is the purpose of any product, right? Well, I asked Alan this very question a couple weeks ago, and Alan is essentially the guy who's been running Harbeth since 1986, and he's also built a reputation for having some controversial opinions as it relates to high-end audio. So I said, Alan, capacitors, internal wiring, binding posts, none of this sounds like you. What's really the story here? And to be fair, he was completely transparent with me in his response by saying, you know what, I hired a brand manager a number of years ago. They looked at our portfolio, they looked at our consumer base, and they said, hey, there's a lot of demand for the better version of what it is you build. Why aren't you doing it? And Harbeth, in their true fashion, had no answer for them. So Alan Shaw went to work on offering this kind of product. And he wanted to make sure it was something that he'd be proud of putting his name on. And this is essentially what they ended up with. And he also wanted to make sure that when it was released, that the original version would still be available for sale. That way he wasn't forcing people to spend more money on the product. So the pricing, I would say, is relatively fair when you consider what it is you're getting. So the regular P3ESR in this instance, we'll just round up and say it costs $2,300 US, whereas the 40th anniversary that you see right here costs $2,900. So it's a $600 upgrade. Obviously, you have the option of whether or not you want to go with the original or go with the 40th. Now, before I talk about the sound, I do want to quickly go over what it is that you get with this speaker. So let's get to that right now. All right, so I'm going to go handheld for this section of the review, and right away, I wish I had better lighting in here so you guys could really appreciate just how beautiful this veneer is. And I like the fact that it's not glossy and that when you rub your hands against it, you can feel the individual grains, and it just adds this sense of class and quality to the P3 that, to me, just gives it a very high desirability factor. Now, like all LS35As, this is a two-way sealed design. On top here, we have a 0.75-inch aluminum dome tweeter, and a lot of people don't know that the P3 actually uses a metal dome tweeter. It's just very well dampened and looks like a soft dome, and some would argue even sounds like a soft dome tweeter. And on the bottom, we have the secret sauce. This is a 5-inch woofer made of radial material. Now, radial material is interesting because it was partially funded by the British government, but what you see right here is actually made by Harbeth, and essentially it's a result of high pressure injection molding, basically using polymer materials. And this is responsible for a lot of the, quote, Harbeth sound. Now, moving around to the back here, slowly, we have our plate, and we have our very expensive WBT binding post, which should work with just about any loudspeaker termination that you can think of. And of course, we also have our grills. If I had any complaint about this speaker as far as build quality goes, it's the little badge that they have that is basically just a sticker. I wish it was more plastic or something like that. But you know what? All in all, I'm okay with it. Now, these grills are magnetic, so if you want to take them off, just use a small magnet and it should come right off. Otherwise, guys, that's going to be your 40th anniversary P3ESR. Now let's talk about how they sound. All right, so when it comes to raw sound quality, I'm pleased to say that both of these speakers sound really good, as they should for the money. Now, to keep things nice and easy, I'm going to address two groups of people. The first is going to be those of you who already own the P3, and you're just wondering, is the upgrade worth it, and what differences can I expect? Once I do that, I'll then transition to the rest of you and just describe the sound of the product. That way you know exactly what you'll be getting into if you were to bring home a set for yourself. So first and foremost, to those of you who already have the P3, the big question is, what are the differences and is the upgrade worth it? And I'll say this, if you have a set of P3s right now and you absolutely love them, love everything about them, then I would say, you know what, hold on to them. Don't turn down the opportunity to audition the 40th anniversary model, but if you love something, well, that's a pretty rare thing in this hobby, so don't fix anything that's not broken and just enjoy them for what they are. But if you really like the P3, but you kind of wish it was a little bit better, right? You wish the bass was cleaner, or maybe the top end was more expressive, or maybe you wish that the speaker was just more open and honest and transparent sounding, then yeah, you should absolutely make the jump, because that's exactly what the 40th anniversaries are. They are the better version of the P3. It doesn't compromise the tone of the speaker whatsoever. You're just getting that same speaker, except better, more honest, more transparent, more articulate. And there's your review. In fact, you don't even need to watch this video from this point moving forward, because you know exactly what I'm laying down. Now, if you don't know what I'm laying down and this all sounds foreign to you, then this is what you can expect from the 40th anniversary P3. So think of it like this. If you're somebody who wants to basically come home at the end of a tough day to sit back and to just listen to your music and to be able to just relax into that music for hours on end without fatigue, then that is who the P3ESR is really geared towards. In fact, going into more specifics, they're really geared towards people who value tone, particularly human speech. In fact, the LS35A, especially these loudspeakers, write a master class on how to reproduce human speech, because it really does sound very natural. You can compare these speakers to other speakers costing as much as $20,000 or $30,000, and many of them won't reproduce the human voice as naturally as something like this. Vocals just sound spot on, whether it's females, whether it's males. In fact, the only time it sounds unnatural is if the recording is just absolute trash. And on top of that, they're really good with instrumental tone, particularly woodwind instruments, guitars. The way the speakers capture the body of the guitar, the pluck of the strings, the resonance of the string, it's absolutely fantastic. And because of their size, everything sounds more or less to scale, at least when it comes to things like the human voice and simple instruments. And it makes for such a great listening experience, and you really have to actually experience it for yourself in order to really appreciate it. Now, overall, these speakers have a laid-back sound. are definitely not going to be for the person who wants that forward and aggressive, you are there at the rock concert presentation. In fact, that leads me into the specifics. So when it comes to treble, for example, the treble is interesting because they do roll it off rather early at around 15 kilohertz, yet because the dome is made of metal, it's still relatively expressive. In fact, that's what I like so much about the P3, is there's this almost grit to the sound that I actually really like, because real live instruments sound that way. They don't sound rolled off and smooth, nor do they sound tilted up and hyped up like a lot of hi-fi speakers. There's rawness to the sound, and that's exactly what these capture. And they do it in a way, though, to where it's not piercing, even with mediocre equipment or poor recordings. And while the 40th anniversary P3s don't exactly put a band-aid over poor recordings like the regular P3s do, you still are able to walk away with a very listenable and enjoyable experience across a pretty wide variety of music types. Now, when it comes to the mid-range, I mean, that's the star of the show. This is why people buy and love the P3s, is because of that natural sounding mid-range. Now, the regular version is a little bit warm sounding, and you still get that tone from the 40th anniversaries, but overall it is going to be a little bit more linear, a little bit more transparent, but you still get that character there, that honesty there. That's just absolutely fantastic. And then you have the bass. Like a lot of little speakers, there's going to be just a little bit of a boost, but it's not as pronounced as with the regular P3s. And really and truly, for something that's this small, and I can't emphasize how small they are. I mean, in a lot of respects, they are smaller than a shoebox. For something that's sealed, that has no cabinet volume, I'm impressed by how much bass Harbeth was able to get out of these speakers. I mean, no, it's not going to be the kind of bass that's going to fill your room with tons of low end. It's not going to be visceral in any way, shape, or form, but it's pretty good. And the same thing goes with dynamics. This is actually a surprisingly dynamic speaker, and you really get to hear that with good classical recordings. I'm very impressed sometimes by just how much air these little speakers can move and just how much impact they can have. I mean, again, it's not visceral, but it's surprising given their size and design type. When it comes to imaging, this is where I think the P3s really do start to stand apart from the regulars in terms of, you know, the nitpicky performance types, because at the end of the day, the regular P3s sound a little bit more limited to the speaker's physical plane, whereas the 40th anniversary models, they really do have more of that typical holographic imaging that you would come to find from a good 2A monitor. So overall, I mean, you just get this excellent, well-rounded package from the Harbeth P3. The last question remaining is, okay, how do they sound with real-world music? Because they are small speakers, and I think the answer is, it depends on your expectations. So if you like a full range sound, then no, you're probably not going to be satisfied with these. You're going to want something that's, of course, bigger and can move more air. That's just physics, right? If you're somebody who likes to listen at loud volumes, once again, you know, these are small speakers, right? I mean, there's only so much that they're going to be able to output before they hit their limit. But if you're somebody who says, look, I don't need to listen at loud volumes, I do like a wide variety of music, but I don't need it to fill my room with tons of bass, then I would say yes. For me, they become their best in a near-field environment. I use my P3s for 7 years on my desktop system, and I think they're perfect. I think the voicing is absolutely perfect, and I listen to all types of music, classical, hip-hop, rock, metal, pop music, you name it, I listen to it, and I think they're perfect in that application. In a regular two-channel application, I think it just depends on taste and expectations. Otherwise, though, they're really good speakers, but they aren't perfect, so let's hit upon some of those imperfections right now. All right, so the good news is this section is going to be short and sweet because I pretty much covered all the main bases. I mean, look, they're small speakers. There's only so much you can expect for something of this size. Now, they're not very efficient, but you know what's interesting? I was actually running an 8-watt tube amp on these speakers, and quite frankly, in a small room at moderate listening levels, even with fairly demanding music, they're just fine. So overall, though, I would say you still want to give them a good 50 to 60 watts per channel on average for most people to cover most listening volumes pretty well. Otherwise, I mean, the only problem with them is the elephant in the room, let's address it, is the price. I mean, $2,900 can buy you a lot of speaker nowadays, which makes these more of a niche option because you have to know what you're getting into, you have to know about their sound, and you have to know that this is exactly what you want. Now, if you're that kind of person, the good news is that these are the kind of speakers that can take you off the merry-go-round. Typically, people who buy stuff like this tend to keep it for a very long time, and they tend to remain very happy with their purchase. So that's the silver lining. But still, you know, they are quite pricey, which means they're out of reach for many audio enthusiast, but otherwise, that's about it, and that leads me to my final thoughts. So, the 40th anniversary P3ESR. You know, in many respects, they're exactly what they should be, which is a better version of the regular P3. They're more transparent, they have quicker bass, the top end is more articulate, and overall you just get better performance without losing the soul and core of what makes the regular P3ESR so fun and engaging to listen to. And I think that's an accomplishment worth celebrating, but we can't ignore the fact that these speakers retail for nearly $3,000, and there is a lot of speakers that you can buy out there for the money. It's a lot of competition. And that makes these speakers something of a niche item. I think they're for the person who's aware of the LS35A history, somebody who wants to own the most modern interpretation of a design that closely resembles the LS35A's core design parameters. I think it's for somebody who likes Harbeth, who appreciates quality control, for somebody who wants a true luxurious good, who is also, like myself, a tone whore, and somebody who doesn't need to listen at loud volumes or to be thrilled with hi-fi spectacular in order to enjoy a soulful, meaningful listening experience. I mean, if that's you, then I think you're going to find a lot of satisfaction with these speakers. And the cool thing is, the resale value on the P3ESR is some of the best in the entire industry. So it's nice to know that it's a rare case where your money can actually go a long way with something like this. Whereas with most hi-fi products, you lose like over half the value pretty much immediately. So, and that says something. They are really and truly good speakers. Clearly not for everybody, but I really like them, which should surprise nobody, right? I mean, I like my P3 so much that I had them for 7 years, and I would love it if I could hold on to these P3s for 7 more years. Anyways, guys, that's just my take on these speakers. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time, peace.
Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own, that's got his own.
Love me like a river does cross the sea. Love me like a river does endlessly. Like a river does. When the dark wood fell before me and all the paths were overgrown, when the breeze of pride sang